हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रॉम चैप्टर 6 एनाटॉमी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एनाटॉमी ऑफ डाइकोट लीफ, एनाटॉमी ऑफ मोनोकोट लीफ एंड सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ इन प्लांट्स। फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डाइकोटिलीडन और डॉर्सी वेंट्रल लीफ, इट्स एनाटॉमी। इन इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डाइकोट लीफ, when we cut TS or transverse section, at that time clearly we can observe internal structure or organization in dicot leaf. It possesses three parts internally. Epidermis is outermost region, mesophyll is middle one, and vascular system is located inside. In this structure, upper epidermis is adaxial epidermis and lower, that is abaxial epidermis, or we can also say upper epidermis and lower epidermis are arranged on upper side and lower side of leaf or cut section. In this structure, more number of stomata are present on the abaxial epidermis. Generally in dicot leaf, in its structure on lower epidermis, the number of stomata are more, and on upper epidermis number of stomata are less in number. There is scientific reason behind this, because upper epidermis is facing sunlight, the possibility of transpiration is more there, and lower epidermis is located below it and not directly facing sunlight. So to avoid excess transpiration, number of stomata on upper surface are lower in number. In mesophyll, middle region, it is made up of parenchymatous tissue. Two type of parenchymatous tissue are located on the basis of its difference in structure. They are palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. On upper side, palisade parenchyma is arranged, and just below it spongy parenchyma is arranged. So this way, mesophyll in leaf, it possesses two regions, palisade and spongy parenchyma. Upper side, the palisade parenchyma, here the cells, they are pillar shaped cell, and in spongy parenchyma, just situated below the parenchyma cell, they are oval to round in shape cells, and both are made up of parenchymatous tissue. Here, numerous large spaces and air cavity between the spongy parenchyma is there. Vascular bundles, it means arrangement of xylem and phloem. It is surrounded by a layer of thick wall bundle sheet cell. So this way, in dicot leaf, epidermis and mesophyll as well as vascular bundles are generally arranged this way. This figure gives us clear idea about anatomy or internal structure of dicot leaf. It is actually TS or transverse section of typical dicot leaf. Here we can see clearly two side epidermis are there, upper epidermis and lower epidermis, that is adaxial and abaxial kind of epidermis. In between both epidermis, mesophyll is there. It means centrally located tissue. It is made up of palisade and spongy parenchyma. We can see palisade mesophyll is arranged upper side just below adaxial epidermis, and below palisade mesophyll, the spongy mesophyll is arranged. Palisade mesophyll possesses pillar shaped cells, and they are compactly arranged. In spongy mesophyll, round to oval shaped cells are there, and they are not compactly arranged, intercellular spaces are there. Actually mesophyll, it possesses chlorophyll, and that's why green in color. In section of dicot leaf, clearly arrangement of vascular bundle we can see here. It is made up of xylem and phloem and surrounded by bundle sheath cell. So this figure, it gives clear idea about arrangement of epidermis, mesophyll layer and vascular bundles in dicot leaf. Here opening of stomata also we can see here, that is the for transpiration purpose pore like structure is there, located on both epidermis of dicot leaf. Anatomy of monocot leaf. It is also known as isobilateral leaf because on both sides they possess similar kind of structure. In typical monocotyledon leaf, actually stomata arrangement are present on the both surface, mostly equally distributed. Like dicot leaf, here mesophyll is not differentiated into pellucid and spongy parenchyma. So this way upper epidermis is observed, lower epidermis is observed, mesophyll is there in between upper and lower epidermis, as well as vascular bundles arrangement is there. Some adaxial epidermal cells in grasses are modified into large empty cells. They are known as gulliform cells. This is a special feature of monocot leaf which was not present in dicot. When the gulliform cells, they absorb water, become turgid and leaf surface is exposed. Due to this reason, the leaf lamina remains open. During water stress, when the gulliform cells become flaccid due to scarcity of water, at that time leaves curl inwards to minimize water loss. So this is a one type of arrangement to avoid excess water loss from leaf. In normal condition, this gulliform cells, they are turgid and leaf, it remains open. But during stress condition where water availability is less, at that time these cells, gulliform cells, they become flaccid and leaf curl. So this mechanism is provided in monocot leaves. By studying this figure, you can clearly having idea about the internal structure or anatomy of monocot leaf. Both side epidermis is present, upper epidermis and lower epidermis. In between that mesophyll is there. We can compare with dicot leaf also. And now we can say here mesophyll is not differentiated like pellucid and spongy parenchymatous cell like structure here. This figure A, can you assume what is A here? Actually it is xylem. What about B? B, they are having the mesophyll cells in between both epidermal layer. Okay. But actually niche in stoma, that is a stomata structure present on lower epidermis, that is opening. The structure here, arrangement of vascular bundle, D figure, that is about phloem. So this figure give clear idea about epidermis on both sides, upper and lower, arrangement of stomata in epidermis layer, mesophyllous arrangement, as well as arrangement of xylem and phloem as a vascular bundle. Secondary growth. Now we have idea about primary growth in plants. Actually due to meristematic activity in plant, radical and plume will develop. So aerial parts and underground parts of plant, they develop. Various tissues are responsible for that. The property of meristematic tissue is that the continue cell division take place. But after primary growth in plants, further growth take place, and this further growth it actually increases girth in plant or plant body. So at that time it is known as secondary growth. Tissues involved in secondary growth in plant, they are mainly vascular cambium and cork cambium. First of all, we are going to discuss about vascular cambium. As you know, the meaning of vascular or vascular bundle, actually it is arrangement of xylem and phloem. Here cambium means secondary meristematic tissue. It is having capacity of cell division, it give rise new cells, and this way girth of plant increases. In case of young stem, vascular cambium is present in pages as a single layer. It is located in between xylem and phloem. Gradually it develops, cell division take place, growth and development is take place between this, and this actually different regions, they complete form a ring like structure at later stage. Now how this cambium activity take place, let's study in detail about activity of the cambial ring. Generally in higher plants, every year this annual ring is developed, that is known as cambial ring due to cambial activity. And in cut stem we can clearly observe this ring. Cambial ring becomes active and begins to cut off new cells, both towards the inner as well as outer side. During this development, cells which are cut off towards pith region, they mature into secondary xylem. So secondary xylem, it means the cells which are cut off towards pith region and they get mature. Cells which are cut off towards peripheral region, they mature into secondary realm. So inner side secondary xylem, outer side peripheral region, it show development of secondary phloem. So now we can say, first of all, during initial growth, initial development, the development, it was the primary xylem and primary phloem, but due to this cambial activity, activity of secondary meristematic tissue, now secondary xylem and secondary phloem develop. Cambium is more active on the inner side than the outer side. And now, as we can understand that the inner side cell, they are actually mature into secondary xylem. So amount of secondary xylem produced here, it is more than the secondary phloem. Primary and secondary phloem, they get gradually crushed because due to activity this cambium, new cells are developed on both sides and they push outside this primary and secondary phloem, and gradually this way crush due to the continuous formation and accumulation of secondary xylem. At some places the cambium form a narrow band of parenchyma which passes through the secondary xylem and the secondary phloem in the radial direction. So during this development, at certain region this type of activity is observed, and the arrangement due to this activity, it is known as secondary medullary rays. So gradually from primary xylem, primary phloem development, after maturity in plant, at certain age secondary growth is observed due to this cambial activity, and secondary xylem and secondary phloem develop in plant. By studying this figure, we can come to know about secondary growth in dicot stem. This is a diagrammatic presentation of secondary growth and various stages. Actually, we can study this by taking TS or transverse section. In first figure you can see that is a cut section or TS of stem. Here epidermis region, cortex region and pith region, as we know very well, it is arranged this way. In vascular bundle, primary phloem and primary xylem are present. In between primary xylem and primary phloem, cambium is present, vascular cambium is present, that is secondary meristematic tissue. What is its property? It continuously divides into cell and give rise on both side cell. So this way gradually further development take place in plant, and in between this interfascicular cambium develop. Then further development, now the secondary xylem and secondary phloem, due to this cambium activity, they show secondary growth in plant. So the new ring develop, girth increases, and actually due to this pressure generally they crush the primary xylem and primary phloem. So gradually due to activity of cambium, secondary meristematic tissue, due to per year this type of ring, due to cambial activity it develops. It is also known as annual ring, and due to its activity girth of plant increases. Spring wood and autumn wood. All you know about wood, what is wood, uses of wood and how you can get wood from plant. Cambium is very active during the spring season but less during the winter. So more activity of cambium is observed during spring season but less in winter. During spring season, a large number of xylem elements are formed having wider vessels, but during winter season less xylem elements are formed having narrow vessel. This is the difference between development during both season, like spring and winter. Due to this activity, wood is formed during summer. It is known as spring wood. But when it is formed in winter season, due to this activity, it is known as autumn wood. So this is the difference between spring wood and autumn wood. Two kinds of this wood appear as alternate concentrating rings in transverse section of a trunk of a tree. It is annual ring, it is known as annual ring, and provide information about age of the tree. So generally it is believed that every year due to cambial activity this ring develop in plant. So when we cut section of this stem in older plant, its trunk region show this type of ring arrangement, and by counting the number of ring we can come to know about of age of plant. It means that number of ring is equal to age of the tree. Heartwood and sapwood. In all trees, the greater part of the secondary xylem, its color is dark in color, its nature is hard and resistance to attack by microorganism and insect. All of you have seen such a type of arrangement in plant. This region is made up of dead elements with highly lignified walls called heartwood. So we can understand heartwood is means that is in colder plants it is dark in color, hard, as well as resistance to attack by microorganism, and it is not made up of live cell, living cells, but dead elements, and they are thickened by lignin. Heartwood gives mechanical support but does not conduct water. Can you assume why? Because here in its composition dead elements are present, so it cannot conduct water and mineral, but in plants it provides mechanical support. So its main function is mechanical support. Peripheral part of the secondary xylem is light in color and it is known as sapwood. Now this sapwood, it is useful for conduction of water and mineral. So you can say in the plant, older plant, this type of differentiated wood, due to this activity of secondary xylem, dark in color, that is heartwood, light in color, that is sapwood. The function of this heartwood to provide mechanical support, and function of sapwood is conduction of water and minerals in plants. Second type of cambium, that is cementitious tissue, that is cork cambium. It develops in the cortex region. Vascular cambium develops in vascular bundle in between secondary xylem and phloem. Now we have clear idea about the arrangement of this. And now cork cambium is also one type of meristematic tissue which develop in cortex region. It is known as cork cambium or phellogen also. Activity of this phellogen, it cuts off cells on both sides. Outer cells, they are differentiated to form cork or phellem region. Inner cells, they are differentiated due to this activity into secondary cortex or phellodem. So this way, development of phellem and phellodem take place. Collectively, this phellogen, it means cork cambium, phellem, that is outer cell differentiation, and phellodem, it means inner cell differentiation, is collectively known as periderm. Due to activity of this cork cambium, pressure builds up on the remaining layers peripheral to phellogen region. Due to this activity, these layers gradually die and fall off. Lenticles. In phellogen, in certain region, this phellogen cuts off closely arranged parenchymatous cell and it is outer side instead of cork cells. This parenchymatous cell soon rupture the epidermis, forming a lens-shaped opening lenticles. We have idea about stomata structure. It present in leaf of plant. Here it present on stem structure of plant, and that is lens shape in structure, rupture structure, one kind of opening, and that is known as lenticles. Its main role in plant is actually exchange of gases in between the outer atmosphere and internal tissue of the stem. We can compare the function with stomata also. In leaf, role of stomata is also is a exchange of gases. Here similarly, it is present on this region of cork and to also permit the exchange of gases between the outer atmosphere and the internal tissue of the stem. In this both figure, actually it is about lenticles and bark. First figure, that is lenticle. In this structure, this idea about the this cells arrange in the epidermis region. Arrangement of cell is there. Gradually rupture cell, that is complementary cells, are also observed. Cork cambium arrangement we can see here and secondary cortex region. So this way, and gradually these cells, they are become converted into structure of lenticle, opening for exchange of gases. In next figure, that is structure of bark. It also possesses dead elements in plants, dark in color. So due to this cork cambium, its activity, we can now come to know idea about the development of such a type of structure in plant. secondary growth in roots. Now we have clear idea about what is secondary growth in plant. It is due to secondary meristematic tissue, and generally girth of plant increases. Vascular cambium of the dicot root originates from the tissue located just below phloem bundle. Portion of pericycle tissue. We have clear idea about the arrangement of pericycle in internal structure of plant. It is present above the protoxylem and it forms a continuous wavy ring. Gradually further development takes place. It becomes circular, and rest of the mechanism is similar as in dicot, which I studied in previous topic also. So this way secondary growth take place here. Secondary growth take place in stem and root of gymnosperm plant. If we talk about monocot plant, here in monocot plant no secondary growth take place. This figure, it is about secondary growth in root, and it suggests various steps of mechanism of secondary growth in root. In first figure, A figure, we can see the arrangement of epidermis layer, cortex layer, and arrangement of primary xylem and primary phloem structure. Gradually, in next figure, we can see the further development of take place and new cells are added. Easily we can compare between A figure and B figure here. C figure and D figure, it gives clear idea about the further development. It means that now the secondary growth takes place due to activity of this cambium, secondary meristematic tissue. Gradually girth increases, secondary phloem and secondary xylem develops. D figure is actually typical dicot root structure, so showing typical secondary growth. Here epidermis layer, now this girth increases, cortex region, primary phloem, primary xylem, as well as annual ring is observed. So this way, due to this activity of secondary meristematic tissue, secondary growth take place here. So in plants, after primary growth, initial growth due to activity of meristematic tissue, secondary meristematic tissue, secondary growth take place, and as we have studied in this all topics, then in later age they show secondary growth.